How can we compute the limit of sinx over x when x goes to 0? And why do we want to do this? Let us start with the why question. The sine function is a really important function for us, describing all kinds of periodic phenomena. Later on, we will learn how to compute derivatives, and in order to find the derivative of the sine, we need this particular limit, so that is why. And how? Well, that is a really nice combination of the squeeze theorem and some geometric considerations, which we'll see in this video. Let us take at a unit circle, so circle with radius 1, and an angle in radians x. That means that this length over here, if you go along the circle, the length of the circular arc will be exactly x. And then we can finish our picture. Then we know the sine of x equals the length of this side divided by 1. So the blue line has exactly line sine of x. And then we see this blue line is smaller than the circular arc that you can see from the picture. So this blue sine of x is smaller or equal than the circular arc x. So this is our first inequality. Now we can do a similar trick with the same picture, but now we make it slightly different. We again have our angle x in radians, and then we draw a line here going up. And then we know that that is a tangent of x, because the tangent of x equals the blue line divided by the 1 equals a tangent of x. And now we want to show that this tangent of x is bigger or equal than x. Well, for that we need to look at areas. Well, first of all, we have the area of the triangle with 1 and the tangent of x. So that area of this triangle equals 1 half times 1 times the tangent of x. And then we also have the area of the part of the circle. Well, the total area of the circle is just a pi. What part of the circle do you have? Well, you go over an angle of x. So the part of the circle is x total circle equals 2 pi. So the part of the circle is x over 2 pi. So the area of this part equals x over 2 pi times the total area of the circle. So x over 2 pi times pi equals x over 2. So the area of the circular section equals x over 2. The area of the triangle equals the tangent of x over 2. Well, the triangle is of course bigger than the circle, so the tangent of x over 2 is bigger or equal than x over 2, or tangent of x equals is bigger or equal than x. So we need those two inequalities for our limit later on. So what do we know? Tangent of x equals sine of x over cosine of x is bigger or equal than 0 if x is between 0 and pi over 2, otherwise this symmetry argument otherwise this geometric argument will not hold. So we can multiply the cosine of x to the right. So you have sine of x is bigger or equal than x times cosine x, and divide by x. So you get sine of x is bigger or equal than the cosine of x. That's the information we get from this picture over here. Then from the first picture over here, we have sine of x smaller or equal than x divided by x. So you have sine of x over x smaller or equal than 1. So that means that we have two bounds on sine of x over x. We know that it's smaller or equal than 1, and we know that it's bigger or equal than the cosine of x for x between 0 and pi over 2. So why do we need this? Well, now we can compute the following limit, x to 0 sine of x over x, because we can nicely squeeze it in. We can use a symmetry to get this to work also for negative x, because it is the expression sine of x over x is symmetric plus minus x, so we can use as our functions f equals cosine x, g equals sine x over x, and h equals 1. Then we can take our limit. If we take the limit x to 0 of f of x and the limit x to 0 of h of x, well, h is trivial because it's 1, the function 1, so the limit is just 1. Taking x to 0 and the cosine, x also yields 1. So that means that our limit from x to 0 sine x over x equals 1, and due to the symmetry, it doesn't matter whether you come from left or right. So our limit x to 0 sine of x equals 1.